I've been having a really nice time, and I thought it was going to be hard work, which it is a bit. But people have been so kind and generous with their comments, so I'm having a great time. I'm tired now at the end of the day.
Penny Dreadful is a show that people really seem to have fallen in love with. Why do you think that is? What is it about the show overall that people love, do you think?
Well, I think it's got a unique flavour. I mean, I think there's no other show like it, and it has elements which have already been proved to be popular, the horror element and the sci-fi element almost, but I think it's also beautifully written, and I don't think you get that type of writing very often on the television, and John Logan, the supremo of the whole thing, has a deep knowledge of Victorian England, and it shows. I think it's a very classy piece of work.
Is it a period of time that interests you particularly, and was that part of what made you want to take on the role?
Well, funnily enough, it wasn't, but since doing the first season, I've actually been reading a lot of Victorian literature, actually. And of course, John uses all the horror genre of Victorian literature, you know, the Dorian Grays and the Frankensteins and whatever, as part of his series. But yes, it is a period of history I do find absolutely fascinating. Now, I've been reading a lot of Dickens, for instance, who doesn't come up in Penny Dreadful, but... No, it's part of that same genre. Well, my character was a bit of a mystery to start with. He's an Egyptologist who works at the British Museum. I don't want to really give away too much, but in case people haven't seen the first two seasons, but he's not what he appears to be. In fact, that's the same of every single character in the series. But he's one of the very few nice people, actually. He's a good man. But he's a very, very camp Egyptologist on the surface. They're amazing. People like Rory Kinnear and Helen McCrory and Timothy Dalton and, you know, Josh Hartnett, Neva Green. Amazing. A lot of them I've known before on doing stage work. So some of them are old colleagues. So it's lovely. And then I have new people to meet, like Harry Treadaway. He's great. Well, I believe they're starting filming very soon. So, with any luck, sometime next year, I would hope.
What are you personally hoping for from that?
Well, I'm unfortunately busy doing theatre. So, I won't be in it as much as I was during the second season, which is personally very disappointing for me. But what I've seen, and I obviously can't say anything about it, it's some very nice writing for me, so I'm happy.
Another project that I have to talk to you about is the Hollow Crown series, which I think is just an astonishing achievement. Can you talk a little bit about why you feel it's so important to see these kind of productions?
Well, of course, a new one's coming out, which completes the almost all Shakespeare's history plays, and I'm really looking forward to seeing that because it completes the story of what I think is important, which is that he was the best chronicler of that period of British history that we've ever had, even if most of it's not true. Shakespeare does it well, and it's a brilliant extended piece of writing. And I'm very pleased today, actually, that a lot of people have come up and said not only about Penny Dreadful but also about the Hollow Crown. So it's obviously hit something in people's, you know, psyche, and I'm very, very pleased about that. These are great, great characters. The character I played, John Falstaff, is one of the greatest characters ever written, and he mustn't be allowed to die.
You know. I mean, even amongst Shakespeare's canon of work, Falstaff is just a uniquely roguish and complex character. Can you talk about what you think makes him such an interesting figure?
Well, I don't think he's entirely pleasant. I think that's the interesting thing. I mean, I think we all know people like this. I certainly do. He likes the pub. He likes to drink. He's a petty thief. So I wouldn't want to spend much time with him in real life, I don't think. But actually there's something unutterably attractive about him. And he's also, as always with Shakespeare, there's complexities in him. I think he knows he's dying from the moment the play, or the film in this case, the Hollow Crown, opens. That it's a man facing his own death and facing the judgment on what his life has been. And I think that's profoundly moving.
Well, one person you spent a lot of time with on that production was our dear friend Tom. I guess fans will obviously want to know what it was like working with him. One of the finest actors of his new generation, I believe.
Oh, he's absolutely amazing. You know, he's marvellous. And I had a great time with him. Yes, what can I say? He's great. And I saw him do a stage Shakespeare last year, in which he was absolutely magnificent. So, Coriolanus. Yeah, the man can do it. That's all I can say. There was an amazing moment when we were doing a very famous and a very long scene. Julie Walters was in it, I was in it, Tom was in it. Five or six people speaking, plus a set of supporting artists, about 20 of them. Very famous scene. And Richard Eyre, the director, said, "I know you all know your lines. I'm just going to roll the cameras and film without rehearsal. And supporting artists, you react absolutely how you would, and let's see what happens." And we did this scene, which was, 20 minutes long. A long scene for film, without any rehearsal. And I cannot tell you how thrilling it was. It was a Rolls-Royce team suddenly really concentrating, and that included all the supporting artists and all the crew, and a big master shot. And I was, at the end of it, it was like, oh, I don't know, it was absolutely thrilling. Absolutely thrilling. Completely fresh, fresh drama. I'm just about to finish a play at the Donmar Warehouse in London, and then I do another play in London. And then who knows, actually. I would love to be involved more with Penny Dreadful, but, you know...